Trump discovers sick thing Raiders are wearing and WH for special operation to bring him down this week. The political climate in Washington since President Trump took office has been strained, to say the least. What should have been a smooth transition from one administration to another took a dark turn when it became apparent that the liberals who lost the election, fair and square, weren't ready to give up yet. The media and Democratic Congress people who are unable to accept the fact that their golden child didn't win, have made every step of the way as difficult as possible for President Trump. Not only has this targeted the commander-in-chief, but every person in his cabinet and on his staff. The result of this constant attack has meant a never-ending inquiry into possible connections between the Trump campaign and Russia, as well as a constant barrage of fishing expeditions, aimed at finding anything at all that can be made to sound like dirt on the president. According to the Daily Mail, Friday's guilty plea by former National Security Advisor Michael Flynn has caused an unexpected result among White House staffers. Everyone seems to have caught on to just how far the liberal prosecution will go and are all fearing for their own reputation, should they even carry on a conversation with someone from the other side. Former National Security Advisor Mike Flynn's guilty plea Friday, the second among Trump insiders, is leading to heightened concern among White House staff that their own conversations could get recorded by other cooperators. Flynn struck a plea deal with prosecutors and was charged with a single count of lying to the FBI on Friday. The plea agreement released by Special Counsel Robert Mueller's office states that Flynn could get reduced jail time for participating in covert law enforcement activities, raising the possibility that he already has been assisting authorities in getting former colleagues to talk. A prior guilty plea, by former campaign foreign policy aide George Papadopoulos, was only revealed to the public in October. He had been cooperating with authorities for months and gave numerous interviews to prosecutors after it was revealed that he had lied to the FBI about his interactions with the professor with Kremlin contacts. The investigation into Flynn's contacts is something that might well be a worthy cause. It is, after all, very important to keep politicians honest. The problem comes in when everyone knows that those who are supposed to be upholding the law are ready and willing to break it in order to get the outcome that they so greatly desire to receive. According to the reports coming from the White House, whether the Flynn investigation is legitimate or not, every person connected to the president knows that their next might be the next on the chopping block if it will get the Democrats closer to pinning anything at all on President Trump. Everyone is paranoid, a person close to the White House told Politico. Everyone thinks they're being recorded. Lawyers representing current and former White House staff told the publication they contacted their clients after the Flynn and Papadopoulos plea deals to ask if they had any conversations with their ex-colleagues that could have been taped. Providing a measure of reassurance is a prohibition on wiretapping someone being represented by a lawyer on the matter being recorded. Many of Trump's most trusted aides have lawyered up in connection with Mueller's Russia probe. White House lawyer Ty Cobb, who has made optimistic predictions about when the probe would end, told the publication he wasn't concerned about Papadopoulos or Flynn being used to tape other officials. Mueller is too good a professional and too good a prosecutor to tape represented individuals, and he doesn't want his office or his important mission to be tainted, Cobb said, noting the legal and ethical constraints. Flynn will provide full cooperation to Special Counsel Robert Mueller in his Russia probe after his stunning guilty plea in federal court Friday morning. My guilty plea and agreement to cooperate with the Special Counsel's office reflect a decision I made in the best interest of my family and of our country. I accept full responsibility for my actions, Flynn said in a statement. Although he pleaded guilty to just a single count, it is what Flynn was prepared to tell investigators that immediately exploded across the political landscape. Flynn said in his statement Friday he was working to set things right. After over 33 years of military service to our country, including 5 years in combat away from my family and then my decision to continue to serve the United States, it has been extraordinarily painful to endure these many months of false accusations of treason and other outrageous acts, Flynn said. Such false accusations are contrary to everything I've ever done and stood for, Flynn said. But I recognize that the actions I acknowledged in court today were wrong. Through my faith in God, I am working to set things right. My guilty plea and agreement to cooperate with the special counsel's office reflect a decision I made in the best interest of my family and of our country. I accept full responsibility for my actions, he continued. Flynn is cooperating, President Trump is cooperating, in fact, every single person that the Democrats and the media attempt to villainize has shown that they are either completely innocent or willing to live up to their actions. There are no witches here, yet the hunt continues.